The first thing I'm going to do is take this stamp, which I have stamped with some Stays On ink, and stamp it here. It's a Hero Arts stamp. Okay. And I am going to take some Glossy Accents, and I am just going to draw on the outline of the flower. And I'm not worried about getting it perfect. I just want to, I'm going to dot dots in here and just go all the way around the outline just to get it all covered so that it'll create a resist so that the outline will stay nice and sharp and black as I start to add colors on top of it. Alright, once that Glossy Accents is nice and dry and shiny, now we can play with it more. Now I just took this Spun Sugar Distress Stain and just went all over, pressing it all over my tag so it gives it kind of a base. And you want to start with a lighter color because obviously it'd be real hard to put the lighter color over a darker color. So start light. And then look at this Tumbled Glass, one of my favorite distress colors. We got a brand new bottle here, so excited, breaking it in. So I am just rubbing it all over that flower, and then I'm just going to need to wipe off, let's see here, there we go, wipe it off any excess, and it leaves some white marks wherever I had the Glossy Accents, but I'm really liking that look there. And then another first here, Brushed Corduroy, my all-time favorite distressing color. Brand new, we're going to use it for the first time. I'm so excited. Okay, so I'm going to start off the tag, and it's not the smoothest of blending that I'm doing here, and that's intentional. That's okay. I'm just going around the edges. I just want to get a little bit of color on all that dark color on all the edges. And then I'm going to go back, let's see, what am I going to do here? Then I'm going to take Antique Linen, and this is one that I've used a lot. I love it. Okay, and then I'm just going to go back and go all over that tag. Just kind of mix that all in there too. It's getting kind of muddy in here, kind of grungy looking, and that's all right because that's what I'm going for. Alright, now I'm just going to set this, it's very hot here today, so I'll just set this in the window and give it a chance to dry before we keep going. Now what I want to do is, this is my Hero Arts script stamp here, and I'm going to use Tumbled Glass and ink this up all over, and I am going to stamp, and I'm not stamping straight or anything, I'm just, and I'll do it again, go all over. And I'm going to tilt it kind of a different angle. And I'm using the Tumbled Glass because I want it to be kind of the same color as the flower, so it really doesn't show up very much on the flower. And I actually didn't let my Distress Stain dry all the way, so that's what I wanted. So when the ink gets on there, it just kind of like blurs, so the stamp is a little softer than it might normally be. Loving that. And I think we're going to work one more stamp in here. I think we're going to work this bird stamp in, and I'm thinking I'm liking it like here. The question is, what color do we want it? And I've decided to go with the Spiced Marmalade color. I think that will work well for what we're doing here. There's the color that we're using there. I'm just getting lots of ink on there. And then I'm just going to stamp Mr. Birdie, I think right about there. Yeah, I like that. So, and I'm also going to kind of, see, have my blue here. Where'd you go? Or Tumbled Glass, where'd you go? Alright, my Tumbled Glass stain ran away from me. It's hiding from me. So, when I find it though, I think I'll go back over to kind of, actually, I'll just use my finger. I'm just kind of smearing this part right here. I just want it a little more distressed, I guess. And actually, I kind of like how that looks. So I'm just putting a little bit of ink on my finger here, and I'm just going to kind of rub a little bit into my flower there. My finger, my number one paintbrush all around inking tool there. Okay. So now that that's done, what else? I don't know. I'm kind of thinking we're good, although I might definitely want to take a little more brushed corduroy, and this time with, and I know that's my green one, that's okay, it'll still work. And I think I want to make this even more dark around the edges. So I'm going to blend on some ink here. And in case you couldn't tell already, we're just going along and creating as we go. I don't really have a plan. I'm just playing with new goodies and having a real good time. Okay, I'm happy with that, except here's the thing. I love, love, love sparkle. And I have some sparkle. In fact, I'm trying to grab my sparkle stuff right now. Here we go. Sunflower sparkle, and I can't believe that this yellow is actually a color that I'm really, really into, but it really is. I'm loving it. I used it a bunch this weekend, and I'm going to be showing you more with it. Yellow's not my thing, but this we're going to make an exception for. And if you look at my collection of distress stains, you're going to actually see a lot of yellows and oranges, because they actually, even though they're not colors I use a lot, they work really well. Kind of contrast with the colors I am using a lot of. Okay, almost there. Just have to get all that sludge off the bottom. Okay, so you don't need very much, just a little bit. I'm way up here by the camera, and we're just going to spray, I think, 2 sprays. Okay, and we're just gonna let that set in. Let's come right down in here so you can take a look at it. Do you see that beautiful sparkle? Oh, love it. Okay, so I think we got it. There is a tag all ready to go.